Good morning, friends. Myself, Professor Prashant Mahajan, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS Institute of Information Technology. So today we will going to see unit number 3, that is engineering materials, and in that we will see two topics. One is polymer and second will be nanomaterial. So let us begin with the unit. So this is the lesson plan for the unit. In that we are going to see engineering thermoplastic, the example is polycarbonate, then conducting polymer, in that we will discuss polyacetylene, then next is biodegradable polymer, in that we will see polyhydroxybutyrate valerate. The next topic is in electroluminescent polymer, in that we will see polyparaphenylene vinylene as example, and in the polymer the last topic is polymer composite, so in that we will see fibers reinforced plastic. So that is about from polymer, and in the nanomaterials we will see its classification, then graphene, carbon nanotube, quantum dots, their structures, properties and application. So this is the lesson plan to be covered in the next 8 lectures. So starting with the polymer. So these are the tube polymers, but they are inorganic. So some of them are given here. So polysilicates, which are present in the rocks, polyphosphates, which are present in your bone, and then third one is polydimethyl germane. So these are the inorganic polymers which are existing, that two are existing naturally, polysilicates and polyphosphates. So introduction to the polymer. So as you studied in your last previous class, that is what is monomer, what is polymer, what is polymerization. So that is the introductory part. So just I'm going to give you highlights of that. So what is monomer? So monomer is the simple chemical substance of low molecular weight which can be converted into polymer, and the molecule of monomer has at least two easily reactive positions. So simply you can remember like this: monomer combines to form polymer. So monomer combines to form polymer. So monomer is a low molecular weight compound and it will form high molecular weight compound. So this is the example of the monomer. So this is ethylene molecule, ethylene, and that is written number of times, that is ethylene, like that. So what happens in that double bond present in the ethylene molecule is going to break, and that will combine to the next ethylene molecule. So there are 3-4 mechanisms of the polymerization, that is free radical, cationic mechanism, anionic mechanism and coordination mechanism. So we are not going to discuss that, but that ethylene, the conversion of ethylene to polyethylene, it is taking place by free radical mechanism. So that free radical mechanism means what? There is an initiator and it is going to create radical. So there is the initiation, propagation and termination steps for the preparation of that monomer to polymer. So this is the ethylene monomer and this is the polymer. So the difference is only that the double bond is going to break and it will attach to the next ethylene molecule. Similarly, the double bond is going to break of the next molecule and it will add to the next monomer. So that is the introductory part. So next is, polymers are giant molecules known as micromolecules and have high molecular weight. So where it is going to be used, or where the polymers are substituted? So first example is metals, woods, cotton, wool, gums, glass and ceramics. So as we know, initially the chairs and tables are prepared from metals and woods. Right now it is prepared from plastic, that is polymer. Then cotton wool, so the clothes which are prepared in it is replaced by polyester, terricot, terry wool, like that. Gums, it is replaced by resins. And glass and ceramics, you can take example of the cups, tea, the cups which you are taking tea. So initially it is prepared from glass material and ceramic. Right now it is prepared from plastic. So polymers are used in automobile engineering. Everywhere polymers are required, like automobile engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, civil, medical and agricultural. So there is a classification based on the occurrence. One is natural, which is natural occurring, that is wood, cotton, wool, leather, silk, cellulose. So that is natural polymers. And synthetic polymers that are prepared by human being, that is man-made. So polypropylene, polystyrene, polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride, polymethyl methacrylate, phenol formaldehyde resin, urea formaldehyde resin, nylon, polyester, teflon and cellophane. That are the some example of synthetic polymer. Then next is engineering thermoplastics. So today we will discuss one topic, that is engineering thermoplastic. So what is engineering thermoplastic? So it is the group, or thermoplastics are the group of materials obtained from polymer resins which provide one or more outstanding properties when compared with the commodity thermoplastic, such as polyethylene, polystyrene, etc. So you can see, if you use engineering thermoplastic instead of that commodity plastic, we will get properties like high thermal stability, then high tensile strength, high impact strength, high chemical resistance, high flexibility, high mechanical strength, lightweight, readily moldable into complicated shapes. So these advantages are useful or giving scope in use at automotive, electrical, electronics, computer component, satellite robot and aerospace. For example, polycarbonate, polysulfonate and Teflon PPV. So these are the some examples of engineering thermoplastic. So we will discuss polycarbonate. So this is the example of polycarbonate. So it is also called as Lixon and Merlon. And polycarbonates are engineering thermoplastics which are polyester. So this is polyester. You can see this is the COR. So this is the COR, that is ester linkage, and that is called as polyester. So you can see the monomers required for this preparation of polycarbonate is, this is called as bisphenol A. So bis means this is phenol 1, this is phenol 2, that is two phenols, and A means that is acetone. So what happens, acetone is having double bond O, and the double bond O, it is removed by taking one hydrogen from this phenol and one hydrogen from this phenol. Okay, so that will become bisphenol A. Then what happens, that hydrogen will react with this phenoxide and it will connect to the O, C double bond O. Then you can write bisphenol A, then diphenyl carbonate, again bisphenol A, again diphenyl carbonate. As it is a polymer, so you can write it number of times. So that will remove each time this phenyl OH group, phenyl OH group, and in between there will be carbonyl group. So you can see, so this is bisphenol A, this is carbonyl from this diphenyl carbonate, and again this is this one, that is bisphenol A. And when we will react one molecule of this diphenyl carbonate, you will get two phenol as a byproduct. So bisphenol A and the diphenyl carbonate is the monomer for preparation of polycarbonate. Then next is properties. So first property is that polycarbonate has high impact strength and tensile strength. That means there will be no effect of the impact and load on the polycarbonate. Then second, high melting point, that is 265 degrees Celsius. Good transmittance, so that is, sorry, good heat resistance, that is up to 140 degrees Celsius. That means we can use it up to 140 degrees Celsius. Very high tensile strength, which already we have discussed. Transparent, that is 1.58 refractive index. Then highly transparent plastic, transmittance is 88%. That means due to that transmittance, we can use it at optical purpose. That means there optical filters, sunglasses, scuba goggles, your computer screen, LED screen, there we can use due to that high transmittance. Then resistance to water and many organic components, but dissolves in organic solvents and alkali. So limited chemical and scratch resistance, no resistance to UV. Okay, so one by one we will discuss that properties by looking at applications. So first is application. So security component, that is used for bulletproof material preparation. Then second is electrical and electronics component, used as insulator in electronics. Industrial plugs, sockets, switches, cover of cell phones, laptops, pagers. Okay, so your mobile phone covers, then your laptop covers, then switches, sockets, plugs, that can be prepared from polycarbonate. Then data storage devices like CDs, DVDs and Blu-ray disc, that are prepared from polycarbonate. Then due to that high transmittance, that is 88%, it can be used in optical applications, such as you can see for making sunglasses, swimming and scuba goggles, safety goggles, visors in helmet, automotive headlamp lenses. So due to that high optical activity, it can be used in the optical applications. Then next, electronic display screen, means your mobile screen, LCD screen, PC lenses, you can use polycarbonate. And last, as a construction material, so due to that high transmittance again and the impact and tensile strength, it can be used as a substitute for window glass, sound wall, etc. So that is the properties and applications of polycarbonate. So one more I forgot to tell you, that is limited scratch and chemical resistance. So you can remember like that your specs or lenses, that specs get scratched, so that is called as limited scratch resistance. So that is the property of polycarbonate, and these are the some applications. So you can see that is the goggles, helmet, visor, then bulletproof glass, then back cover, then headlamps, CDs, bulletproof jackets, and that is car glass. So that is the polycarbonate, its preparation, its structure, its properties and application. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you.